Greetings, traders, and welcome back. Thank you for joining me yet again. Chris here, bringing you another survival guide. Today's discussion will be based around the exponential moving average. It's a slightly more complicated version of the simple moving average, but all in all, it is still extremely easy to use and understand. So if you are a new trader, this is definitely going to be something that should be friendly for you, especially if you're talking about passing that gauntlet mini with your friends. But without further ado, let's show you how you can apply the exponential moving average to your chart, otherwise known as the EMA. That way you can follow along the entire time during today's video. In order to do so on the Finamark platform, we're going to go up here to the top center and click the Show Indicators Options button. Then we're going to scroll down to where it says exponential moving average. It's the second on the list at the moment. Give that a click and we are all set. Now, by default, this is a 14 period exponential moving average, and if you want to change yours, you can do so by coming back over here to the Section 1 tab, clicking the cogwheel, where you'll then see that you can change the color as well as the period to whatever you so choose. But without further ado, let's get going. Each and every day, the pool of technical indicators available to traders grows a little deeper as more are thrown into it. Now, some of the very first indicators out there are still around today, and usually they're still being used today for good reason. One of these indicators is the exponential moving average. It is one of the first to be thrown into that proverbial technical indicator pool. So, what is the exponential moving average? Well, the exponential moving average is usually referred to as an EMA because it saves you that mouthful of words, and it's just an advanced version of an SMA, which we know is a simple moving average. The concept is simple. It is going to put greater weight on the most recent data points in comparison to data points that are farther in the past. The idea here is to pay more attention and apply more analysis to the most recent occurrences in the market to attempt to give us a more accurate view of what is currently happening and what is currently about to happen. That is the general concept. The EMA ensures that the old and redundant data points do not have the same influence on the indicator as the latest data point. That's the general concept here. And this is different from calculating the simple moving average, where all data points quite simply just have the same weight and we're provided with a simple average. The disadvantage of the simple moving average, some argue, is the fact that if everything is weighed equally, it's not going to give us an advantageous look at what is currently happening, which is where most traders want to focus. With the EMA, on the other hand, it's more responsive to current changes in the market by placing more weight on the latest developments in price. Just like the simple moving average, the EMA can also be customized to the trader's needs and wants. For all of my math-savvy traders out there, if you are one of them, this is the formula of exactly how the exponential moving average is calculated, as well as the multiplier. So what we have here is a situation where this T is going to be representative of the instance that needs to be calculated. So that means if a T1, a T-1 I should say, is in the equation, that means it's the previous instance, hence the -1 portion. Other than that, it's relatively self-explanatory. We have our closing price, our multiplier plus our EMA, and then we have our 1 minus our multiplier. And once again, our multiplier is going to be our smoothing factor divided by 1 plus the number of days. So the math as far as the calculation of the exponential moving average isn't overly complicated, but it is not something that you will most likely need to ever do. I only share this so you understand exactly how it's coming from instead of just taking my word or the indicator's word, which of course I never encourage blindly following anything. When we put the qualities of a simple moving average on the left, with the right side being the exponential moving average in the same areas, we can start to see how they really differ. With the simple moving average, we know that it treats each data point equally, with weight for each data point being 1 over n, where n is the number of days. So put simply, the simple moving average is quite literally a simple average of a period that is being averaged together. The EMA is going to put more weightage on the recent data points like we discussed by replacing the weight used in the SMA by a multiplier. Now, with the simple moving average over here on the left, only the number of days can be changed to alter the sensitivity of the simple moving average line. With the exponential moving average, the scaling factor and the number of days can be adjusted to change the multiplier. With the simple moving average, it is less responsive to the latest price point because everything is equal in a simple moving average. With the EMA, it is more responsive to the latest price point. With the SMA, we are slower in detecting a trend or a reversal of a trend, more or less due to the point right above it, the fact that it's less responsive to the latest price point. Whereas with the EMA, we are faster at detecting a trend or a reversal of a trend because it's paying more attention to current price. And with the SMA, for calculating the N-day SMA, where 1N is the number of days, a history of points are required. But with the EMA, a history of N plus 1 price points is required. The first EMA, however, would be based on an SMA, since a historical EMA is unavailable after the completion of N plus 1 days. Now, if this is sounding confusing, I promise you it's not nearly as confusing once we throw one on the graph here and play around with it, and that's exactly what we're going to do. Here, we have a graph of the E-mini S&P 500 with two exponential moving averages already applied to the chart. One of the exponential moving averages is set to a setting of 12 periods. That is the blue line. The orange line is a period of 26 as far as the setting goes, and the reason behind this is the 12 and 26 period EMA crossover is one of the most common EMA strategies that traders are using today. The idea is quite simple. Traders are using price action in conjunction with paying attention to when the 12 and 26 period EMAs cross over each other, and regarding which direction they cross will dictate which way they're looking to trade. Over here where we have A marked off, we can see that the blue line, which is our 12 period EMA, the shorter term one, which will follow price closer, is crossing below the orange line, which is the 26 period. This is a read for traders using this strategy to look for an opportunity to sell because it is an indication of bearish momentum. It should be noted that this strategy can and is applied with simple moving averages as well, but the timing of the crosses will vary because, once again, the more recent data with the exponential moving averages is weighted heavier, which in some regards will cause these crosses to happen sooner, which is what a lot of traders are usually looking for. They want the earlier signal, but it's only going to be a matter of preference as to which one is going to be your favorite. So I recommend trying out with both of them. But as these lines continue on, we notice another scenario occurring. We watched over here where A happens again, where the lines then cross back the other way. That means the 12 period crossed on top of the orange line, which is the 26 period. When this occurs, traders are usually using this as an indication to go long. It's an expectation of bullish momentum because the short term is getting ahead of the average of the longer term, being the 26 period. So this is the 12-26 period crossover strategy. Traders will use this strategy to look for an opportunity to get in for both long and short, and usually they can use the same strategy that they're using to get in as the reason to close out a position as well. If we look at this second A example where we would have gotten in for a long, the next time the lines cross, we can use that as an opportunity to exit, which occurred over here. So we could decide to close our trade out at this point because the same reason that we would want to get out of a long position is the same reason that the EMAs are now telling us that we have bearish activity to come. And obviously, we don't want that to be occurring if we're in a long position. Another variation of the EMA crossover strategy that's quite popular is done with the 5 and 8 period settings. Now, this is going to be one that is going to respond way quicker, and we're going to see these lines much closer together on average than with the 12 and the 26 period, just because 5 is closer to 8 in regards to what they're measuring. So, as such, there's not going to be an expected large deviation between 5 and 8, as you may see with something that is 12 to 26, where there's a lot of different periods in between 12 and 26, quite obviously. Now, with the 5 and 8 EMA strategy, this is one that is favored by traders that are attempting to get quick scalps out of the market because it responds so quickly. It may be hard to see, but over here at our A setting, we actually had our blue line cross above our orange line, and in this case, the blue line is representing the 5 and the orange line is representing the 8, so this would be our opportunity to go long. With our B over here, we have it going the other way around. Ignore the fact that I apparently can't draw circles, and we crossed the other way around. So we had the blue line fall below the orange line, which is an indication of potential bearish momentum to come. But once again, these lines are much closer together in terms of the period. So they will cross back and forth over themselves far more frequently, or may even look like they're just riding on top of each other to the untrained eye. So this strategy favors a more experienced trader due to the fact that the lines are so close together so frequently. As far as using an exponential moving average as part of our technical indicator tool bag, there are some notable advantages. We have the fact that it is simple to use. It is literally a line that is illustrating an average of what price has been doing. It's also very versatile. It's versatile in the fact that it can be used on essentially anything that can be charted. And on top of that, it's applicable to both long-term and short-term analysis. It doesn't matter if it's a 5-minute chart or a monthly chart. An average will always be an average. Whether it's the exponential kind or the simple kind, this applies to both. So it's versatile, easy to use, and can be used pretty much anywhere on any time frame. There are some potential drawbacks that should be mentioned as well, such as the ability for it to create false signals. Now, the false signals are something that is going to come from the moving averages potentially crossing over themselves preemptively while the market is moving itself into a range in the case that you are using a moving average cross strategy like we already discussed. So it's up to the trader to make sure that they're using outside analysis instead of just blindly following the moving average alone. And also, it is a delayed read. It's a lagging indicator in nature. It is going to follow behind price, which means it is never going to be up to the exact moment of what is happening in the market because it's averaging historical data that has already occurred together, whether it be the simple or the exponential. And then we have the fact that it does work better in conjunction with price action, which honestly kind of ties into what I was just saying with the false signals category. So it's not much of another drawback. It's more of another way to touch on it. And that's, once again, it is something that really doesn't do tremendously well as a pure standalone strategy. But once we apply it with something as simple as paying attention to outside price action or some type of other candlestick patterns, it can become a very, very powerful tool without a whole lot of extra input. Let's take a look at the live charts that we applied the EMA to at the very beginning of the video, now that we understand some of the strategies that can be used with EMAs, as well as how it works. As we can see here when we're scrolling through the charts, there's some notable things that are happening here that should definitely draw some attention to your trading brain. And one of them is the fact that when the moving average is below price or when it's above price during a trendy market, the market will at times almost use it as a dynamic area of support or resistance. And if we focus in on this portion of the chart right here, we can see that during this period of time, we had a break right here on the left. Price broke above the moving average. Then it continued to ride and bounce on top of it as it traveled higher and higher and higher until ultimately it broke and fell below price, at which point you saw a lot of resistance being treated around or being created around the area that the moving average is now being plotted. So the moving average can do a lot of stuff for us. It can be an opportunity to get into into the market for both longs and shorts when we use two of them in conjunction with each other and then pay attention to the moments when a shorter term one crosses over a longer term one and vice versa. But also we can pay attention to them even just by themselves as a potential area of support or resistance, almost like a trend line. When the market is working its way upwards, the moving average is going to hold to a certain degree, obviously adhering to its average, and price will at times find a way to magnetize to it and bounce off of it while it's maintaining a certain trend. And if it's a bullish trend, you'll notice that the market will at times continuously bounce off of it like we saw here, and the same will hold true in a bearish market. So the moving average is one that is so darn simple to use. I think everybody should be aware of how to use it and what it is, but it is something that has the ability to be applied to a million other strategies as well because of how clean it is. It's literally just a line that is going to move through your current price charts, whether they're candlesticks or whatever you have them applied to. You can apply the moving average to anything on any time frame, like we said. So it can always be used as an added layer of confirmation for other strategies if you're not interested in using it as your main strategy with a cross plus price action. But other than that, I appreciate all of you joining me for another survival guide here with your old pal, Chris. And before you go today, please, if you can do me a favor and click that like and subscribe button down below, I would greatly appreciate it. But until next time, guys, happy hunting, happy trading. I'll see you all very soon.